What about the unhealthy foods?
Fast food can be delicious, but it can affect your body.
Sometimes we prefer unhealthy food because of the flavor. Have we ever compared it?
Do you know the top 10 fast food restaurants in the whole world? And whoa, 75% of portion increase in fast food restaurants.
What are the difference between healthy and unhealthy food?
Healthy means healthy foods benefits your body in a very good way. Also, healthy foods are called non-GMO, that are organic or that are natural and organic. The healthy foods have carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, and minerals. And everyone needs those nutrients and minerals. And the unhealthy food are called GMO because they are not natural, they are processed or made in fabrics or something like that. They are full of sugar and fat and lots of processed ingredients like a lot of sodium that is bad for your blood pressure, and it also has a low nutritional value. And here are some examples of healthy food that usually eat this, and unhealthy food that usually eat this more not very often.
Okay, so how many fast food restaurants are in the world? There are 50,000 fast food chains in the United States and 500,000 fast food restaurants in the world. And Americans spend $100 billion on fast food. And then, like it says here, the fatter the country, the fatter the people.
What are the top 10 global fast food chains? The top 10 is Papa John's, and it has about 755 international restaurants. The top 9 is Dairy Queen, and it has about 802 international restaurants. The top 8 is Dunkin' Donuts, and it has about 3,005 international restaurants. The top 7 is Domino's Pizza, and it has about 4,422 international restaurants. The top 6 is Burger King, and it has about 4,998 international restaurants. The top 5, Starbucks, and it has about 527 international restaurants. Top 4, Pizza Hut, it has about 5,809 international restaurants. Top 3, Subway, and it has about 10,109 international restaurants. And top 2, KFC, and it has about 11,798 international restaurants. And the top 1 is McDonald's, and it has about 18,710 international restaurants. These are some examples of the fast food restaurants. Here it's a graph of the top burger restaurants by the visitors. According to this graph, we can see that almost half of the in-store visitors prefer the McDonald's burgers, and only about 3% prefer the Carl's Jr.'s burgers. How many people eat fast food in the USA? About 50 million Americans are served daily, and the people that eat 7 times a week are 6% of the whole Americans.
This is the fast food nation. It's like a graph of fast food restaurants in the U.S. or how do they eat or how much do they eat. So here it's the cities that spend the most of fast food. First is Plano, Texas. Then Madison, Wisconsin. Wichita, Kansas, Akron, Ohio, Fort Wayne, Indiana, Kansas City, Kansas City, Chandler, Raleigh, Baton Rouge, and Omaha for the last one. And how much more than the national average does this city spend on fast food? Plano is 1.3x. No, that no, that is like extra. Fast food capitals are these ones that be down. Where is the most fast food restaurants in that state? McDonald's is in Louisville, Kentucky. Subway in Miami, Florida. Burger King in Orlando. Wendy's in Miami. Taco Bell in Orlando. Pizza Hut in Orlando. KFC in Orlando. Arby's in Louisville.
How does unhealthy food affect our body? Fast food affects our body in different ways. Eating snack foods that are high in calories contribute to weight gain. Unhealthy food cannot benefit our body. Fat, sugar, and other ingredients are not good for us. Eating unhealthy food might cause diabetes, weight gain, or obesity. Unhealthy food might get us sick, make our stomach hurt, or even worse pains.
How have the proportions of fast food changed over the years? So the studies have shown that since 1955 there was a 75% of portion increase in fast food restaurants. McDonald's, as Ballet said, McDonald's has the biggest like food chain, restaurants chain, and it also has the biggest portion increase. Since 1995, the rate of portion increase actually has the biggest increase. Yes, since 1995, since 1955, it was the greatest increase from then to now. And according to USDA, the average moderately active female should be consuming around 2,000 calories a day. A moderately active male should be consuming 2,500 to 2,600 calories. And as you can see here, the soda fountain drink size changes. Since 1955, you can only order only one size of soda, and it was the McDonald's large soda, so it was the largest and the only one with 7 ounces. And in 1980, you can order a big, two extra cups, and as you can see, it increased like a lot, like the big gulp from 11 to 12 ounces, and McDonald's large soda, that it was like this in 25 years ago, it was like this, and in 1980, McDonald's large soda, it was like 21 ounces. And in 1990, it was bigger. The big gulp was 40 ounces, and McDonald's large soda now is 32 ounces. And then this is another graph in 1995, you can order only this size, only this portion size that was 3.9 ounces, and the average man weight was 166.3 pounds. And then in 2006, the hamburger portion size increased like 4 times bigger. If they ate like a lot of this, the average man weight was about 194.7 pounds. Here's like what will happen like about 2050. The hamburger size will be obviously more bigger than those two. And the man weight will be a lot bigger. According to nutritionsecrets.com, here, like some foods that affect a lot or that have a lot of like calories and sugar. The salty snacks with 93 calories higher. Here, like comparing from 1995 again to now, the salty snacks were 93 calories lower than now. The french fries were 68 calories less than now. The desserts and soft drinks, 49 calories less than now. Fruit drinks, hamburgers, cheeseburger, pizza were 97 calories less than now. And the Mexican food with more calories, with 133 calories more from 1977 to 1978. These unhealthy sources of food represented 18% of the calories consumed in the United States. That number increased from 1994 to 1996 to 27.7%. And here, the research is.
These are all the resources that we use. And check out all of these for more information.
Thank you for listening.
Okay, wait, don't take your presentation down yet. Questions? I have a question. Go back one slide, that one where it says the Mexican food. That caught my eye because I'm eating a lot of Mexican food, obviously, these days. Why do you think Mexican food's calories increased so much? Do you have a guess?
Because you know that there's tacos and burritos and enchiladas. It has a lot of now processed food now that we know that it could be like more delicious and more attractive to people. So they put like a lot of processed food and sugary things and a lot of things that increase a lot the calories. And people really don't care about the calories, just that it's appetizing and delicious.
Okay.
And then I think that, by the way, this information is from the United States, not from here in Mexico. Mm-hmm. Because here in Mexico, I think that like the Mexican food is obviously original. And in the United States, it's like, well, they're in the United States, not Mexico, so it's not like original.
Oh, so you think that it's different?
Yeah.
It's different Mexican food. Yep, that makes sense. And then also, you were talking about GMOs. What is GMO?
The GMOs are like the processed food that they are made in laboratories or in factories. It's actually like you take away one gene from an organic food and you put it to another root or something like that, and it could grow that same food, but it will be more tasty or more bigger than the normal size. But they could produce more. It's all about like the money they get. Yes.
Okay. Anybody else have any questions for him? Okay, great job, guys. I would